The 24th of August 1853, first potato chips prepared by Chef George Crum at Moon's Lake House near Saratoga Springs, New York. George Speck, also known as George Crum, was an American chef. He worked as a hunter, guide, and cook in the Adirondack Mountains and became noted for his culinary skills after being hired at Moon's Lake House on Saratoga Lake, near Saratoga Springs, New York. Speck's specialties included wild meat, especially venison and duck, and he often experimented in the kitchen. In 1850s, while working at Moon's Lake House in the midst of a dinner rush, Speck tried slicing the potatoes extra thin and dropping the slices into the deep hot fat of the frying pan. Although recipes for potato chips were published in several cookbooks decades prior to 1850s, a local legend associates Speck with the creation of potato chips. Speck developed his culinary skills at Carey Moon's Lake House on Saratoga Lake, noted as an expensive restaurant at a time when wealthy families from Manhattan and other areas were building summer camps in the area. One of the regular customers at Moon's was Commodore Cornelius Vanderbilt, who, although he savored the food, could never seem to remember Speck's name. On one occasion, he called a waiter over to ask, "Crum, how long before we shall eat?" Rather than take offense, Speck decided to embrace the nickname, figuring that a crumb is bigger than a speck. By 1860, Speck had opened his own restaurant called Crumbs on Story Hill in nearby Malta, New York. His cuisine was in high demand among Saratoga Springs tourists and elites. His prices were those of the fashionable New York restaurants, but his food and service were worth it. Everything possible was raised on his own small farm, and that, too, got his personal attention whenever he could arrange it. According to popular accounts, he was said to include a basket of chips on every table. Guests were obliged to wait their turn, the millionaire as well as the wage earner. Mr. Vanderbilt was once obliged to wait an hour and a half for a meal. With none but rich pleasure seekers like his guests, Speck kept his tables laden with the best of everything, and for it all charged Delmonico prices. The New York Tribune ran a feature article on Crumbs, the famous eating house on Saratoga Lake, in December 1891, but mentioned nothing about potato chips. Neither did Crumbs commission biography published in 1893, nor did one 1914 obituary in a local paper. Another obituary states, Crum is said to have been the actual inventor of Saratoga chips. When Wicks died in 1924, however, her obituary authoritatively identified her as follows: a sister of George Crum, Mrs. Catherine Wicks, died at the age of 102 and was the cook at Moon's Lake House. She first invented and fried the famous Saratoga chips. Wicks recalled the invention of Saratoga chips as an accident. She had chipped off a piece of the potato which, by the merest accident, fell into the pan of fat. She fished it out with a fork and set it down upon a plate beside her on the table. Her brother tasted it, declared it good, and said, "We'll have plenty of these." In a 1932 interview with the Saratogian newspaper, her grandson, John Gilbert Freeman, asserted Wicks's role as the true inventor of the potato chip. A 1973 advertising campaign by the St. Regis Paper Company, which manufactured packaging for chips, featured an ad for Speck and his story, published in the national magazine Fortune and Time. During the late 1970s, the variant of the story featuring Vanderbilt became popular because of interest in wealth and names, and evidence suggests the source was an advertising agency for the Potato Chip Snack Food Association. A 1983 article in Western Folklore identifies potato chips as having originated in Saratoga Springs, New York, while critiquing the variants of popular stories. In all versions, the chips became popular and subsequently known as Saratoga chips or potato crunchers. The 21st Century Snopes website writes that Crumb's customers, if they existed, were more likely to be obscure. Vanderbilt was indeed a regular customer at both Crumb's Malta restaurant and Moon's Lake House, but there is no evidence that he played a role by requesting or promoting potato chips.
Thank you for watching till the end. Please consider encouraging us by subscribing to our channel. In order to show your support, don't forget to like and share the video.